further instructions. Thank you.
So they did not derail the antelope, but it did cause enough damage that the antelope limped into the next station. The Jupiter was available. They attached the cars to the Jupiter, and the Jupiter brought those dignitaries in. So neither one of the locomotives was supposed to be here on that day. Both of them ended up being in the right place at the right time. And here they are. They went right back to work right after, and both of them, not just the 119, but the Jupiter, was scrapped for her metal, early 1900s, still only $1,000 a piece. Now I need to walk around those locomotives, so hold on. Oh, it looks like you guys are on the wrong side of the track. I'm going to go to the other side. I'll be right back. Just kidding. I do have to walk around it, but just a minute. The fuel source, and we said that the 119 was a coal-burning locomotive, and we said this one was a wood-burning locomotive. Now, you tell me why. Why would Union Pacific use coal and Central Pacific use wood? Exactly. There's no coal on the West Coast. There are no coal mines at this time in the West Coast. And coming across Nebraska, Union Pacific cut down all the trees. Just kidding. There was no trees. I used to tell that story, but I got a complaint against me because somebody believed that that's what I said. And I mean, that I really was serious. Wow. No, there's not a lot of wood coming across the plains, right? So, but on the west coast, they're coming through the Sierra Nevada. Lots of wood, lots of availability to wood. So they needed to use wood. The Union Pacific needed to use coal because they didn't have the wood as a fuel source. Just like the ties. Did you guys notice the difference in the two ties? These are all box cut, and these are hand hewn. The Central Pacific, having a lot of access to wood, they built sawmills and actually box cut their ties. The Union Pacific, not having access to wood or much access to wood, when they got into the Uinta Mountain area, they actually hired men to hand hewn their ties. And that's how their ties are made. I know you keep staring at me kind of weirdly, but I still got about 3 minutes. That's okay, right? He loves to hear these stories because he's never heard them before. Okay, maybe that's not true. Maybe you have heard them before. I don't know. So who's gonna help me do the highball today? But do you think you're gonna be able to do that with me? No? No? Okay. We'll find somebody to help me. Do you think you'll be able to help? Oh, we've got a volunteer. Somebody will help me. Okay. So did you guys have any more questions about the two different locomotives and why they're different as far as fuel source or anything? How are you doing? How are you doing? Good. What's your name? Andy? Andy, I need to tell you what I just did. I just walked all the way around the locomotive. I checked the tracks that way. And I checked the track that way, and it looks like everything is clear. So when it is time, we have to check the time to make sure we're leaving on time. We're going to look at that engineer right in the eyes, and we're going to tell him it's okay to go. Okay? Because he can't leave without us letting him know that everything is clear. Okay? And how we do that is we use a term. It's called a ball. You know what a ball is, right? You heard that part? Okay. So practice, say high ball. Huh? The right one. We're going to use the right one. And we have to look them square in the eye. Okay, so we're going to wait. We got about a minute and a half, and then we'll let it go, okay? That's okay? Did anybody have any questions about the last spike site? Where is the last spike site now? It's still there. You're talking about the spikes itself, right? You know, we talked about Leland Stanford was the president of the Central Pacific Railroad. He was also the governor of California. Stanford University, anybody heard of that? It's all the same guy, okay? He had his nephew, Hughes, make that spike. So when everything was all done and over with, you know, they grabbed those spikes and they immediately put them in their pockets, okay? The owners of them. Put them right in their pockets, and they left about as quickly as they came, okay? So right now, it's at Stanford University at his museum. Stanford University at his museum. So in Palo Alto, California. I understand a couple of weeks ago somebody tried to steal it. So I think they took it off display until they could get a better security system to put it back out. So you can imagine what would happen if we had it out here. And somebody tried to steal it there. That would be whatever. This is the last fight site, and that's the Laurel Atoll. Right after the one Jupiter leaves, you'll be more than welcome to check it out, okay? It looks like we're ready. Okay. And you're not going to cross that. I'm going to turn my back on you. You're not going to cross that line, right? Good deal. Thank you. Are you ready? Looking straight in the eye. Lift up your hand and say,
"Hi, ball.
Ladies and gentlemen, the final showing of the Golden Spike movie will begin in the Visitor Center in just a minute or two. If you want to see the final showing, please come to the Visitor Center at this time. It will be shown in the Visitor Center main auditorium by the museum and exhibit area. Thank you.
Did we mention the Visitor Center? Jupiter's going to go down to the far end of that Y intersection because she needs to back up. So she's going to be switching tracks way down there. You might be able to see the engineer or the fireman get down off the locomotive and switch it. And then she will be backing up. So then she'll be coming closer to our direction.